Hello viewers, welcome to LMNN classes. I am your Wallace Saheb. In this video we are going to discuss about Kalman cycle or C3 cycle. So here it was first discovered by the scientist Malvin Kalman and his co-workers James Bassam and Andrew Benson in the year of 1950 by using chlorella and senedesmus. So here chlorella and senedesmus both are the species of algae which are used in their experiments. And then they supply the radioactive carbon as a source to the algae. So here the algae which are growing in the laboratory, they require certain amount of carbon source as a nutrients. So here the required nutrients which are provided by the scientist in the form of the radioactive carbon to the algae. So here they supplied the radioactive carbon as a source to the algae which are growing in the laboratory, and then they killed all these algae in the boiling methanol to extract a certain amount of content. So here, why did they kill all these algae in the boiling methanol? Because of here, to extract a certain amount of content, all these algae which are killed in the boiling methanol. So here the species of algae which are growing in the laboratory, all these cells which are killed in the boiling methanol to extract a certain amount of content which consists all the radiolabeled compounds. Then the radiolabeled compounds were separated from the extracted content of algae by paper chromatography. So here the paper chromatography is a technique which was essential to separation of all the radiolabeled compounds from the extracted content of algae. Then finally, autoradiography to determine all the radiolabeled compounds in the extracted content of algae. And then there are three carbon compounds was the first formed stable product in the Kalman cycle. So here the three carbon compound was the first formed stable product in the Kalman cycle, and then subsequently some other intermediary compounds were also identified by the scientists in the Kalman cycle. And then there are number of reactions which are occurs in the Kalman cycle. All these reactions are controlled by enzymes. All these reactions are controlled or catalyzed by enzymes, and their sequences were also identified by the Malvin Kalman and his co-workers during the period of here 1946 to 1953. So during this period they discovered or they identified the sequences of reactions in the Kalman cycle. And finally, Malvin Kalman got the Nobel Prize in the year of 1961. So here, the Kalman got the Nobel Prize for the discovery of Kalman cycle in the year of 1950. So here, they got Nobel Prize in the year of 1961 for the discovery of Kalman cycle or the C3 cycle in the year of 1950. So here this is brief introduction about the Kalman cycle. And then there are three different kinds of the steps which are involved in the Kalman cycle. They are carboxylation, reduction and regeneration. So there are three main steps which occurs in the Kalman cycle. They are carboxylation, reduction and regeneration. These are the three main steps which are involved in the Kalman cycle. They are here carboxylation, reduction and regeneration. I will show the simple diagrammatic representation all these reactions, like here the RuBP, which is a 5 carbon compound which accept the atmospheric carbon dioxide and further it converted into phosphoglycerate, 3 phosphoglycerate, and further it reduced as here glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate or triose phosphate. And then it is again involved in the regeneration of RuBP. So here in the first reaction or in the first step, the carboxylation reaction. So here the carboxylation reaction, the 5 carbon compound accept the atmospheric carbon dioxide and further it converted into phosphoglyceric acid. This is the 3 carbon compound, which is a first formed stable product in the Calvin cycle. So here the Calvin cycle, which is also known as here C3 cycle. C3 mean the 3 carbon compound was a first stable product in the Calvin cycle. So here thus the Calvin cycle, which is also known as here C3 cycle. And then this is the first reaction, that is carboxylation. And then second step, the reduction process. So in the reduction process, the 3 phosphoglycerate is converted into the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate or triose phosphate. It is a two-step process. It is not directly converted into the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. But first it is converted into the 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid in the first step of reduction. Then further 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate is converted into glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate or triose phosphate. So here in this reaction there are ATP and NADPH molecules are required. So here the required ATP and NADPH molecules, which are provided by here light reactions, So during the light reactions, there are assimilatory powers like ATP and NADPH molecules are produced. So here these produced assimilatory powers, which are further utilized in the dark reactions for the reduction phase. So here the ATP and NADPH molecules or assimilatory powers, which are produced during the light reactions, further utilized in the dark reactions. And then the utilized ATP and NADPH molecules are reduced as here ADP and NADP plus after the reduction process. And then the triose phosphate molecules, which are involved in the synthesis of hexose sugar, that is here the sucrose, and further it is converted into the starch. When the continuous synthesis of the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate in the Calvin cycle. And then the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate or the triose phosphate, which is further involved in the regeneration of RuBP. That is here the primary CO2 acceptor of the Calvin cycle. So here the third step of the Calvin cycle is here regeneration. In this process, here also the ATP molecules are required and releases ADP. So here the ATP and NADPH molecules, which are also required in the reduction process, in addition to the ATP and NADPH, here other ATP molecules are also required for the regeneration of RuBP in the Calvin cycle. So here this is about the brief introduction of Calvin cycle. So this is the diagrammatic representation of the Calvin cycle. And then coming to the reactions of Calvin cycle. So we will discuss the detailed explanation of the So here in the Calvin cycle, the first step is a carboxylation. Here carboxylation is a most crucial step in the Calvin cycle. So in which the six molecules of RuBP, accept the six molecules of carbon dioxide and six molecules of water, and further it converted into 12 molecules of phosphoglyceric acid. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme Rubisco. So here, in this carboxylation reaction, the 5 carbon compound, that is here RuBP, which is a ketone sugar. So here the 5 carbon compound RuBP accept the carbon dioxide molecule from the atmosphere, and further it converted into the 12 molecules of phosphoglyceric acid in the presence of Rubisco. So here the Rubisco is a enzyme which is most abundant protein in the plant kingdom. It has a dual nature because of it is involved in the both carboxylation and oxygenation reactions. So it has the carboxylase activity and oxygenase activity. Due to the presence of carboxylase and oxygenase activity, which is involved in the both carboxylation and oxygenation reactions. And then further catalytic activity of Rubisco enzyme, the magnesium ions are required and red light is also required. So here the magnesium ion is a inorganic cofactor, and red light, which is essential to the catalytic activity of Rubisco enzyme. So here in the carboxylation reaction process, the enzyme which is involved, that is here Rubisco. Ribulose 1,5 bisphospho carboxylase oxygenase enzyme, which has dual nature, that means it has carboxylase activity and oxygenase activity. So here in the carboxylation reaction, the 6 molecules of RuBP accept the 6 molecules of carbon dioxide from the atmosphere in the presence of water, and further converted into 12 molecules of phosphoglyceric acid. So here the phosphoglyceric acid is a 3 carbon compound. So here the 3 carbon compound is a first formed stable product in the Calvin cycle, hence it is also known as here C3 cycle. So here the plants which undergo the C3 cycle or the C3 pathway, which are considered as here C3 plants. So here the plants which are only undergo the C3 cycle or C3 Calvin cycle. So here that kind of plants which are referred to as here C3 plants. So here the Calvin cycle which is occurs in the C3 plants. And then in the carboxylation reaction process, before the formation of phosphoglycerate, here another one unstable 6 carbon compound is produced or formed, that is here 2-keto-3-carboxy-arabinitol 1,5-bisphosphate. So here this is the 6 carbon compound, intermediary compound in the carboxylation reaction, which is unstable. So very soon this unstable intermediary compound further converted into the 3 carbon compound, that is phosphoglyceric acid. So here this is about the carboxylation reaction. And then coming to reduction reaction. So here the second step of the Calvin cycle is here reduction. So here in the reduction process, the phosphoglyceric acid, which is produced in the carboxylation, then it is further converted into or reduced into the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, which is occurs in two steps. So here the reduction is a two-step process. Which is occurs in the two steps. In the first step of the reduction, here the 12 molecules of phosphoglyceric acid reacted with the 12 molecules of ATP, and further it converted into 12 molecules of 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid. 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid. So here 12 molecules of phosphoglyceric acid reacted with the 12 molecules of ATP molecule, and further it converted into 12 molecules of 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme, that is phosphoglycerokinase. So here in the first step of the reduction, the phosphorylation process means the phosphoglyceric acid is phosphorylated with ATP molecule, and further it converted into 12 molecules of 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid. So this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme phosphoglycerokinase, which is simply represented as here PGK, phosphoglycerokinase. And in the second step of the reduction process, the 12 molecules of 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid, which is reacted with the 12 molecules of NADPH, and further it is converted into 12 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate and 12 molecules of NADP plus and 12 molecules of H2PO4 minus. So here these are the end products of this reaction. So here in the second step of the reduction, here 12 molecules of 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid reacted with 12 molecules of NADPH, and further it converted into 12 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate and releases 12 molecules of NADP plus and 12 molecules of H2PO4. So here these are the end products of the reduction process. So here in the reduction process, the second step, which is catalyzed by the enzyme, here glyceraldehyde 3 phospho dehydrogenase, this is the enzyme which is catalyzed in the second step of reduction reaction. So here the second step of the reduction reaction, which is catalyzed by the enzyme glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate dehydrogenase. So here if you are simply saying as the 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid is converted into glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate when it is reacted with NADPH molecules and releases NADP plus and H2PO4. So here this is the reduction process. So in the reduction process, there are 12 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates are produced. 12 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates are produced. Out of the 12 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates, here 5/6 of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates, that means here 10 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates which are involved in the regeneration process, but 1/6 of, that means the 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates which are involved in the formation of 1-hexose sugar, So here there are 12 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates which are produced in the reduction process. Out of the 12 molecules, here the 10 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates which are involved in the regeneration of RUBP, and further 2 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates involved in the synthesis of hexose sugar, that is glucose. So here out of the 12 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates, here 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 are exported from the chloroplast into the cytoplasm, chloroplast into the cytoplasm because of this total Calvin cycle, which is occurs in the stroma of chloroplast, which is occurs in the stroma of chloroplast. So here, where does the Calvin cycle occurs in the chloroplast? So here, it is particularly occurs in the stroma of chloroplast. So here, the produced glycerol here 3 phosphates. There are 2 glycerol here 3 phosphates exported from the chloroplast into the cytosol to the synthesis of hexo sugar. So here, where do the hexo sugars are synthesized in the chloroplast? So here, particularly, the hexo sugars which are produced are synthesized in the cells, cytoplasm or the cytosol. So here, out of the 12 molecules of glycerol, you had 3 phosphates. Here, 2 molecules of glycerol had phosphates are involved in the synthesis of 1 hexo sugar. So here, these are exported from the chloroplast into the cytosol. And then this is about the reduction reaction. And then third step of the Calvin cycle, that is here regeneration. That is here the regeneration. So here, in the regeneration process, so here the third step of the Calvin cycle is here regeneration. So here the 10 glycerol here 3 phosphate molecules are which are involved in the formation of regeneration of here RuBP, which is a primary CO2 acceptor in the Calvin cycle. So here, in the regeneration process, the first step is here the 2 molecules of glycerol here 3 phosphate, which is isomerized into 2 molecules of dihydroxyacetone phosphate. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme triose phosphate isomerase. So here, in the first step of the regeneration, here the 2 molecules of glycerol here 3 phosphates are isomerized into the 2 molecules of dihydroxyacetone phosphate. So here, the glycerol here 3 phosphate is a first formed sugar in the Calvin cycle. And then the second step of the Calvin regeneration is the 2 molecules of glycerol here 3 phosphate condensed with 2 molecules of dihydroxyacetone phosphate to form 6 carbon compound, that is here 2 molecules of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. So here the glycerol here 3 phosphate is a 3 carbon compound, dihydroxyacetone phosphate is also 3 carbon compound. Both are condensed to form a 6 carbon compound, that is here fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. So there are 2 phosphate moieties are present in the fructose, at particularly first position and 6th position. This reaction was catalyzed by the enzyme here aldolase. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme here aldolase. And then the third reaction of the regeneration, that is here the 2 molecules of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate dephosphorylated into 2 molecules of fructose 6-phosphate. So there are 2 inorganic phosphates are released from the fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme fructose 1,6-bisphosphatase. So here, in the third step of the regeneration, here the 2 molecules of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate dephosphorylated into fructose 6 phosphate. So here there are two inorganic phosphates are released in this reaction. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme fructose 1,6 bisphosphatase. And then the another reaction of the regeneration, that is here two molecules of fructose 6 phosphate reacted with two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. And it is further converted into two molecules of xylulose 5 phosphate and two molecules of erythrulose 4 phosphate. So here the fructose 6 phosphate is a 6 carbon compound and glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is a 3 carbon compound. So here both are condensed to form a 5 carbon compound, xylulose 5 phosphate, and 4 carbon compound, that is erythrose 4 phosphate. So here this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme transketolase. You can easily represent as here TK, transketolase. And then the fifth reaction of regeneration, that is here the two molecules of erythrose 4 phosphate, which is condensed with two molecules of dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Two molecules of erythrose 4 phosphate reacted with two molecules of dihydroxyacetone phosphate to form two molecules of 7 carbon compound, that is pseudoheptulose 17 bisphosphate. So here the erythrose 4 phosphate is a 4 carbon compound and dihydroxyacetone phosphate is a 3 carbon compound. So here both are condensed to form a 7 carbon compound, that is here pseudoheptulose 17 bisphosphate. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme here aldolase. And then the sixth reaction of regeneration, the two molecules of pseudoheptulose 17 bisphosphate dephosphorylated into two molecules of pseudoheptulose 7 phosphate and releases two molecules of inorganic phosphate. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme pseudoheptulose 17 bisphosphatase. This is the reaction of the regeneration. So here the 7 carbon compound pseudoheptulose 17 bisphosphate is dephosphorylated into pseudoheptulose 7 phosphate, releases two inorganic phosphate. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme pseudoheptulose 17 bisphosphatase. And then the seventh reaction of the Calvin cycle regeneration is here the two molecules of pseudoheptulose 7 phosphate reacted with two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate to form two molecules of xylulose 5 phosphate and two molecules of ribose 5 phosphate. So here two molecules of xylulose 5 phosphate and two molecules of ribulose 5 phosphate, both are 5 carbon compounds which are produced in the seventh reaction of regeneration. So here the pseudoheptulose 7 phosphate is a 7 carbon compound and glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is a 3 carbon compound. Both are condensed to form a 5 carbon compounds. They are xylulose 5 phosphate and ribose 5 phosphate. So here these are the two sugar. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme here, the transketolase. And then in the eighth reaction of regeneration, here the two molecules of xylulose 5 phosphate from the seventh reaction and also the two molecules of xylulose 5 phosphate from the fourth reaction. Total four xylulose 5 phosphates converted into the 4 ribulose 5 phosphate. So here the 4 xylose 5 phosphate. 4 mean 2 from 7th reaction, another 2 from 4th reaction. So there are 2 xylose 5 phosphates are produced in the 4th reaction, and also 2 xylose 5 phosphates are produced in the 7th reaction. So here the total 4 xylose 5 phosphates which are epimerized into the 4 ribulose 5 phosphate. Ribulose 5 phosphate. So here this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme ribulose 5 phosphoepimerase. And then the 9th reaction of the regeneration of Calvin cycle is here. The two molecules of ribulose 5 phosphate, sorry, here the two molecules of ribose 5 phosphate, which is isomerized into the two molecules of ribulose 5 phosphate. So here the ribose is the aldose sugar and ribulose is a keto sugar. So here the ribose 5 phosphate is further isomerized into the ribulose 5 phosphate. So this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme ribulose 5 phosphoisomerase. This reaction. So here last step of or the last reaction of the regeneration of Calvin cycle, that is here. There are 4 ribulose 5 phosphates from the 8th reaction and there are 2 ribulose 5 phosphate from the 9th reaction. Total 6 ribulose 5 phosphates are 6 ribulose 5 phosphates are reacted with 6 molecules of ATP to form 6 molecules of RUBP and 6 molecules of ADP. So here the 6 molecules of RUBP means 6 molecules of RUBP is regenerated at the last step of the regeneration. So here when the 6 molecules of ribulose 5 phosphate reacted with the 6 molecules of ATP molecule from the and further converted into 6 molecules of RUBP and ADP molecules. So here this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme here, the ribulose 5 phosphokinase is the enzyme which is catalyzed to the last step of the regeneration of Calvin cycle. So here these are the total 10 steps which are involved in the regeneration of RUBP. So here out of the 12 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates, there are 10 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates which are involved in the regeneration of RUBP. So here let us count the 10 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates. Here 2 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates in the isomerization, again the dihydroxystone phosphate is converted into glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. So here there are total 4 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates in the first reaction. Again here the 2 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates, and then here glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates again in the 7th step of the reaction. So here the total 10 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates which are involved in the regeneration of RUBP, which is a 5 carbon compound. So here the remaining 2 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates which are exported from the chloroplast into the cytosol for the synthesis of hexose sugar. So here this is about the carboxylation, reduction and regeneration. These are the 3 main steps in the Calvin cycle. So here energetics of Calvin cycle. So here what are the inputs and what are the outputs of substances in the Calvin cycle? So let us see the inputs and outputs of Calvin cycle. So here the 6 molecules of carbon dioxide which is converted into hexose sugar. And then how many ATP molecules are involved, are utilized in the Calvin cycle. So there are 12 ATP molecules in the reduction and there are 6 ATP molecules in the regeneration. Total 18 ATP molecules are utilized in the Calvin cycle and releases 18 ADP molecules. And then in the reduction process, the number of NADPH molecules, there are 12. So here 12 NADPH molecules are utilized in the Calvin cycle and further releases 12 molecules of NADP plus molecules. So here this is about the input and output of Calvin cycle. And then for every formation of or for net gain of one triose sugar, how many ATP molecules are required, how many NADPH molecules are required, and how many Calvin cycles are required, how many CO2 molecules are required, and how many Calvin cycles are required. Calvin cycles are required. So here for net gain of one triose sugar, here 9 ATP molecules are net gain, 9 ATP molecules are net gain, and 6 NADPH molecules are required and 3 carbonyl molecules are required and 3 turns of Calvin cycle is required for the formation of 1 triose sugar. But for the net gain of 1 hexose sugar, the net gain of ATP molecules are here 18. And net gain of NADPH molecules means the required ATP molecules are 18 and the required NADPH molecules are 12 and required carbonyl molecules are 6 and required Calvin cycles are 6. So here when formation of 1 hexose sugar. So here for the formation of 1 hexose sugar, here 18 ATP molecules and 12 NADPH molecules and 6 carbon dioxide molecules and 6 turns of Calvin cycle. These are the required to the formation of 1 hexose sugar. And then for the formation of 1 sucrose molecule. Sucrose is a disaccharide. So here for the formation of sucrose molecule, how many ATP molecules are required? So there are 36 ATP molecules are required and 24 NADPH molecules are required and 12 carbon dioxide molecules are required and 12 turns of Calvin cycles are required for the formation of 1 sucrose. So here sucrose is a disaccharide. So here this is about the energetics of Calvin cycle. Already I discussed this kind of energetics of Calvin cycle in the previous video. So here this is about the Calvin cycle.